Hello, coffee drinkers. Welcome to Chordbook Mission Control. We're sitting here side by side working on the book. We're even sharing an ottoman today. Life goals to get separate ottomans, perhaps. Although, I don't know, it's kind of pretty cute. Playing footsie, you guys don't need to know any of this. Let's face it. So I just finished all the text. Pretty much all the text. I'm sure there are going to be additions and edits and, oh, we need this, we don't need that. And Chelsea is going to tell me, man, you talk too much. Again, because she's already told me that. She's nodding her head here. She's like, but it's nice seeing the progress and seeing it all kind of come together. So T minus about, I don't know, 4 or 5 days or something like that. Oh, I'm just giving her a minor heart attack, putting those kind of numbers out there. But T minus some number of days, hopefully in single digits. Should we go with that? Yeah, okay, I got a big seal of approval on that, so really we're not that far away. Okay, enough about the book, more about the bass. It's a funky little bass, it's from Italy, from the 60s. Ooh. And there was a question on the vlog, which I should get to quickly, about whether I have the compressor on all the time. Yes, I do. I have the Miura M2 compression pedal, and it is on all the time. That's kind of my standard signal chain right now. Sometimes I'm using the Noble preamp DI, and then that's all going into the Tonehammer 500. That's kind of the basic signal chain without any other effects. There are, of course, other pedals on my board, the loopers, the volume pedal, the delays, all those standard things that you guys have seen me use a million times before. But in terms of the compression, that's what I use. Now, interesting comments that have been coming up in terms of getting a compressor or having some kind of compression in the signal chain. I noticed a couple of people were saying, maybe if I was gonna have it on all the time and didn't need to get to it, that they would buy a rack mounted piece of outboard gear and mount it in a rack with their amp head. That is very like 70s, 80s, early 90s, I think. Just in terms of traveling around. I mean, if you don't have to move around anywhere and that's in your studio, that's awesome, but in terms of traveling, I couldn't imagine having like a big, even if it was a single rack space, like a big piece of rack gear, and then having to put that in a case with the amp and carry that around in a flight case or check that on a plane. I think that would be super prohibitive in terms of the ease of movement when I'm on the road. So I love the pedal option, even though I do leave it on right now pretty much all of the time. So I'm not sure about that. I don't think I would recommend it. Speaking from experience as someone who really travels a lot to play, and kind of I've been trying to dial in my setup for many, many years. And of course it's constantly evolving and getting updated, but for now I can highly recommend whatever compressor you go out and buy. If you're looking for a compressor, it doesn't have to be the M2. That's my, you know, that's my preferred compression pedal. But whatever you buy, I highly recommend getting it in pedal form because it's way more compact, way easier to move around with. I just spent the last 15 minutes talking utter nonsense to the camera and trying to play this bass, which is an awesome bass, but it's falling apart. And half of the shit doesn't work, and I'm not very comfortable playing it, and I just spent some time trying to make a vlog about playing this bass, and it was utter bullshit. And sometimes you have to know when you are trying to flog a dead horse and when you should give up and move on to the next thing, because it's not helping anyone, including myself. So the intention was there to make a vlog about this bass, which is an awesome bass, don't get me wrong. It's funky. In fact, here's like 10 seconds of me talking utter crap about it and playing it really badly. That sounds like ours. You know what I mean? So, yeah, so today I'm ditching this. I'm going back. Maybe I'll come back and do that another time where I'll get it set up and, you know, it'll be comfortable to play and it won't keep cutting out, and Chelsea won't have to make fun of me or giggle when I hit the wrong buttons because it's got pickup selectors that are buttons, not switches. And part of what I was talking about in that vlog that you will now never see, thankfully, you can be very thankful for that. I'm thankful for it. You should be equally thankful because it was utter nonsense. But one thing I was talking about was that I'd spent the past few days playing 4-string basses and like getting back on that kind of in that mode, you know, from writing the book and recording the DVD for the core book. And it kind of highlighted to me, like just playing the four strings again, how without that extra string, how much more position shifting you have to do, how much more accurate you have to be, and you know, how much more creative you have to be with that one less string. Having said that, it's really nice to hold this bass in my hands again. I haven't played it since we shot the DVD like 4 or 5 days ago. And when the workload is this intense, it really shows me how little time I get in the day to practice. And I do, like I've said before a lot, I do sacrifice practice time with the instrument to try and stay in shape and go to the gym and make sure I maintain that kind of health element of my routine. So there were some comments. I ended the vlog a few days ago with some playing, you know, with some practicing, and a few people were saying, hey, it's nice when you end the vlog with music, like from a concert or from a practice session. So I haven't played this bass in a while. I haven't really practiced in a while. So let's make today's vlog about that and what that means to come back to the instrument after a few days kind of real off time and really not thinking about it or being conscious or definitely not playing it at all. And hopefully in the next 5, 6, 7 minutes, I can get from feeling actually quite stiff and uncomfortable. I'm playing these first few chords. They don't feel that great under my fingers. I definitely am aware that I haven't practiced. And let's see if in just 4 or 5 minutes, we can turn that into something musical and find a direction and find a path, find a reason to be practicing. Always good to be inspired when you're practicing. So that's what these next 4 or 5 minutes are all about. This is literally in real time as it happens. Mistakes and all. I'm not gonna edit any of this stuff out. I definitely feel like that's a little too quick in terms of the tempo, so I want to dial it back a little bit. Just kind of finding my accuracy and seeing where everything is at. Am I feeling relaxed? Is it calibrated? Is my brain calibrated to play this instrument again? I have been playing kind of shorter scale four strings for the past few days. Already I've come up with a melody that I quite like. My first reaction is to put that in the looper. Fresh in my mind are all of these reharmonization techniques that I've been putting in the book and filming. So kind of going through that a little bit is kind of really the last thing that I was thinking about musically. So it's pretty fresh. And what I'm hoping to get out of this is a chord sequence to improvise over it and possibly develop this little melody and turn that into kind of an ostinato and come up with a bigger melody for more of a composition, more of a song. So I wouldn't normally stop and talk for a couple of seconds after that, but this is really what my goal always is when I sit down to practice, is to get to music as quickly as possible, to get over the whatever technical road bumps are in my way in terms of my comfort level with the instrument and get to something compositional, improvisational, just get to something musical as soon as possible. And mission accomplished in just a few minutes, which is a great sign for the rest of the practice session. Not to bore your brains out with 45 more minutes of that, but that is kind of where I would go. Probably not as dense, it's gonna get a little sparser. I'm probably gonna get into more melodic playing. There's just that element of haven't played for a while and getting a lot of aggression out in the music a little bit, I would say. And I would also say that kind of applies to a lot of people I hear who do like one thing like a lot of the time. Like, I don't know, like play just one style of music all the time. and then they get a chance to go out on a jazz gig and overplay like crazy. So I try and add that overplaying element to the early stages of my practice routine, so that not only do I not do that, hopefully not do that when I get out on the gig, but most of my experience with the instrument and playing music is not spent doing that. Yes, of course, I maintain my chops and my technique so that when I hear that crazy idea that goes all over the instrument angularly and at breakneck speed, yes, I can execute that. But my goal is not to have huge technique and massive chops just to use them all the time for the sake of it, for, you know, to impress people or to get people to clap or cheer or something in the club. So really, really good idea to be conscious of that, be conscious of where you're at with your practice routine, where you're at with your performance situation, and how you kind of manage how dense or not your melodic content is, or your playing in general. So I'm feeling a little better about today's vlog. So happy that I didn't share all that bullshit that I tried to film about the Goya earlier on and actually got to some music. It wasn't what I set out to do, but like I said before, really important to know when it's just time to get rid of an idea or to give up on an idea and move on to the next thing and focus your energy in the right place. I'm gonna play out of today's vlog with a little more music, with this loop, with this new chord sequence, with this new kind of melody riff, and see if I can trim down the density of what I'm playing and find some melodic ideas. That's definitely the goal from here on out with this practice routine. So today's vlog is done. I will see you guys tomorrow.
So